We should also address intuition, because if we could spot child molesters through intuition, millions of women would not marry abusive stepfathers. While going with your gut, if you get a bad feeling about someone, is great. Now we have, okay, this is my colleague. I work with him all the time. We're in the country club together. He couldn't possibly be a child molester. I would have known through my intuition. Therefore, if he is, what does that say about
me?
Therefore, it could not have happened.
Yeah, that's why, and I think a lot of his former partners and some of the juvenile judges there, and the president of the private defender association, I guess, who defended Ayres, said he would send his own grandkids in here. That was a few years ago, but and it, because it reflects badly on their judgment and their choice, right? So, I know that feeling.
I think that one of the things that you brought up about that people would second guess their own judgment when they knew it was a medical doctor, I think there's probably not too much that can be said about that, because most people would not presume to judge that a medical doctor would not be in the right place to be doing a physical exam. Mm-hmm. Because that is, a psychiatrist is a medical doctor first, and then a psychiatrist as a specialty. So I actually think in this case, having, you know, just hearing about it, that I think a lot of people make that judgment. If it kept on being called, it was a physical, it was a physical.
Yeah.
And child, and even Children and Family Services, if the social worker, it sounds as though, is making the judgment, the doctor has determined this was the right thing to do. What I don't understand is that upon people finding out from a child that it wasn't a physical, that it was actually molestation, that's where, that's the piece that, you know, I don't know if that if you're fact finding, if you had stories about that, of, you know, the molestation actually being described. And I have one. I mean, I was sort of wondering if there was more of that. Or
well, some parents didn't believe the kids, a law enforcement officer told me she can't believe how often that still happens. But what I want to say is, I know there was the McMartin case where the little kids were, but they were 3-4 years old, very suggestible. And then I know when Ayres was arrested, some crackpot guys, older guys, came to, they were victims, but they weeded them out quickly. But let's just, a 12 or 13-year-old boy has a hard enough time talking about sex with their parents. What boy is really going to bring up the fact that he was molested to his parents? It's shameful and embarrassing. So, I mean, that, I guess if your son is saying that, you really have to pay attention. Like, it's just too...
Why would he go?
I mean, it's just the thing. And so that happens in all kinds of abuse cases. Parents don't believe them. So I guess parents, as embarrassing as it is, you better... Or at least keep asking questions and find out what happened.
Is there any evidence that Dr. molested girls?
No.
No.
He's interested in
the boys. I think the gentleman's point over here about supervisory board, I mean, for lawyers, since Gideon versus Wainwright, which now dates back to 64, direct appointments from the bench that were suffering from the same problem have been held unconstitutional. And I think the same thing, that's the easiest single point thing I'm hearing as a humble citizen that could be changed, is to demand that there be an organization that monitors these people. It won't be perfect, but it's better than direct appointments. That would be my thought.
Good idea.
I think it should be up to a dad too, your kids.
In the late 60s, the 70s, and the 80s, Ayres was seeing everybody in this county, all the kids.
One of the boys, and that's not...
Especially for Millbrae, growing in San
Mateo. A man went to the California Medical Board in 1994 to say he was molested in 1966. He was out of statute, but the medical board never went to the San Mateo Police Department. So I don't quite know. They only discovered that when they were investigating here. So it seems like, I don't know. Yeah. Shouldn't they have told the police, even if it was out of statute, right?
Yeah.
Seems like a lot of people...
So it's there to be flagged later,
I know.
No, I have to agree with Glenn Beck that there should not be a limitation on the statute. there should be no statute of limitations for child molestation. Because you're talking about ruining a kid's life.
Yeah. And most, this is most men don't really come forward until their mid-30s. That's when it starts hitting them. And they've been all that time, they've been running away from it. And then, you know, they've been drinking or whatever. And then it hits, it's only 36, 37, 38.
Well, there's no statute of limitations on murder. And that should be the same thing for child molestation. Because you're killing a kid's life.
You are. You're killing your souls. And
following on to that, part of it is, as a child, they're a lot of times not able to even look at it or deal with it. It's so shame-producing, like somebody had said earlier. And I think that it's probably not until they get older and they can't take it anymore, and it's continues to come up and haunt them, where finally somebody, you know, says or, you know, can even look at it. And so I have to agree. I think the statute of limitations on that is really a crime.
It's different for everything. Well, I contacted the Senator Yee's office, and they said, well, about statute of limitations, they said, well, they couldn't do it in California because the prisons are overcrowded and the city had told me that. But if you guys want to, you know,
I've got a couple of stories about Ayres. When the kid became uncontrollable about not wanting to see Dr. Ayres, Dr. Ayres would tell the family, use the juvenile court, Schwartz is up there, he'll take care of it, and then we had a mental health staff, so he would send his rejects, who were probably, now that I reflect on it, resisting him and hating him and acting out in his office, and they sent him up to us, and we found them pretty normal that they didn't disclose when we would interview them, because they were sent up as mentally ill kids to our juvenile hall. We became the incorrigible center for fallout from the psychiatrists, because we did treat them humanely up there, and we did have a full medical staff examining if there was any physical problems.
Did he risk something in terms of disclosure by sending him to other professionals?
Well, you could. But we just took it. Because the stories would come out, this kid was beyond the control of the parent and Dr. Ayres. Well, that's the ironic part, and I just do suspect.
You're asking whether Ayres would risk disclosure by sending a kid up who might tell someone that the real reason he was resistant to Ayres.
That was my question.
And I think the sad thing is a lot of the kids in that system are afraid. You know, nobody's going to believe them, and there are going to be worse consequences.
They may have been told, but no one.
Well, Ayres did tell about who's going to believe in one case, and one of the victims of the statute, he said, who's going to believe you? I'm a doctor, you're a troubled kid. Which is when I would hear that. I did hear of a case, or learn of a case, where a boy who had been examined by the pediatrician went into Ayres' office. He refused to let Ayres take off his clothes, and Ayres was very angry about it. He told the mother, I can't do anything for your son. I mean, that's another red flag. He's there for... I don't know. Do child psychiatrists just sort of give up on kids like that so easily?
He would.
Yeah, he would. Well, obviously, but it just seems that's a red flag. It's just weird. Because he wouldn't. And I think the woman's husband was a doctor, too. So it was just a very. He would, dismiss them if they. Happy to see them close out.
I want to ask about whether there's any ongoing investigation by any medical board in relationship to this defense that it was just a physical exam. It seems like there's some work that needs to be done to regulate that. I mean, you shouldn't be doing something like that without parental permission or knowledge.
That's right. Well, I think that's what the Academy is trying to address. So that's why Dr. Lynn Ponton, who reported there to the medical board, she's on the nominating committee, and she couldn't come today. She's in Arizona, but she's going to bring it up.